Amazing story of a ghostly mirror.
It's night time. All the members of the house have finished dinner. Two kids, Pinky and Chintu, go to their elder sister. Chintu says,
Didi, why don't you tell us a story today?
Didi replied,
Go and sleep. It's very late.
Huh? We are not feeling sleepy. Tell us a story and then we'll go to sleep.
Didi lays Chintu and Pinky on the bed near her and then she starts telling them the story.
This story takes place many years ago. In Bangalore city, purchasing a flat in a tall building, new people arrive to stay there. Rajesh, his wife Rashmi, and their little son Yash, a family of three. Yash was 8 years old. One day, just as Yash enters his bedroom, suddenly he hears someone laughing. He looks at the TV, but he sees that it's off. He's shocked. After some time, he hears someone crying softly. He turns around and he sees someone's faint face in the mirror. He gets scared. A voice is heard from the mirror.
Yash bhaiya, don't be scared. Listen to me carefully.
Huh? Who are you? And how did you get into the mirror?
A voice spoke from the mirror.
Even I was a living, innocent child like you once. My name was Abha. I was too young. My mother used to say, a little guest is gonna arrive in this house soon. She asked me one day,
Beta, do you want a brother or a sister?
I said, a brother. But luck had something else in store. One day there was a flood in the river near our village. The flood destroyed many villages. Even our house was destroyed. Me and my parents got caught in that flood. I used a wooden door to save myself. My life was saved, but my parents were nowhere to be found. I became an orphan. My uncle kept me in his house. He loved me very much. But I never stayed in the house for long. My aunt never saw me as someone she loved. She used to scold me all the time and beat me too sometimes. She was very greedy and wanted to take over my whole village property. That's why one day she mixed poison in my food and killed me. Ever since that day, my soul has been wandering around. I live in this very mirror, but I can come and go anywhere. God has given me some special powers.
Abha said after a pause.
When I saw you, I started thinking, Wish, I had a brother like you.
Yash stared up. He said to Abha,
You know, I don't have a sister. Why don't you make me your brother? I promise I'll never trouble you. Would you like to play with me, Abha?
Abha said while chuckling,
I can definitely play with you. But to watch you play would make me more happier. I could talk to you. We can joke around. I can even help you, Yash bhaiya.
Abha once again smiles and says,
One more thing. As per my wish, only you will be able to see me. Nobody else.
Yash liked Abha's talks very much. In little time, he became fond of Abha. One day, as Yash was going out of the house, because of the strong winds, a branch from a nearby tree breaks. And just as it was about to fall on him, the wind stops. And this was Abha's magic. Abha giggles, and even Yash feels happy. The people nearby are shocked. They had never seen a wonder like this. One day at school, Yash gets into a fight with a tough kid. When he's about to hit Yash, his hand stops in midair, as if someone had put brakes on his hand. Huh? He gets slapped in the face. He gets scared
becomes worried and starts running away. All the other kids start laughing and clapping. Yash knows who is doing all this. Yash is sitting in his class and his class teacher asks him,
Yash, show me your notebook. Have you done your homework?
Yash gets scared because he didn't do his homework. His teacher approaches him angrily. But suddenly, her anger turns into a smile. She says, Yash, sit down. You are a really good boy. Yash is amazed. Abha giggles. Yash looks at Abha from the corner of his eyes and starts smiling to himself.